Hello friends, my name is Dennis and I'm here in Research Triangle Park, North Carolina at the UL facility where we're gonna go inside the lab and see some of the behind the scenes of what it takes to make firefighter equipment safe. So right now I'm in the helmet footwear lab here at UL. I'm here with Terry. Say hi, Terry.
Hi, Terry.
Now, tell me what you do here at UL.
I'm an engineering technician here. We do a lot of different types of evaluation of products.
Now, why is helmet testing and footwear testing so important?
Well, it's just one very unique part of an ensemble for firemen's protection. We're trying to protect them when they're doing their job. And so this is just a very key part for the head protection. This is a pretty fun test. What we have here is we have like a head and call it a cranium, and we've got this big tower. We know the weight of this thing, and we measure the speed of how fast it's falling. And when it impacts this anvil, we'll have an indication of how many G's or how hard it hits, basically, what kind of force that we had on it. Ready?
Okay, yep, go ahead. That is loud.
All right. Yeah, a little loud, but it's safe.
I'm here at the harness test area here at the UL Labs, and with me here is Javon. Say hi, Javon.
Hi, Javon.
So, Javon, what do you do here at UL?
Here at UL, I'm a laboratory technician, and I test multiple fall protection products to ensure public safety. When first responders are out in the field rescuing an individual, we want to make sure that these products will not fail and are capable of rescuing someone to safety.
Oh, okay. So Javon's job here is very, very important to make sure that the firefighters or people who go out and need this kind of equipment are able to do so safely. Let's check it out how it all works. Okay, so can you explain how it is that you put this all together?
Yes, how we put this together is we'll dress this torso in a full body harness to a snug fit, meaning we'll tighten up all the straps to make sure that this harness is very tight on this torso. We'll then attach the attachment points where we want this harness to fall from, and we'll raise it up to a particular height, and we'll press this quick release mechanism to allow the torso to free fall, and we want to ensure that this torso does not make contact with the ground.
3, 2, 1.
So we're now in the footwear test lab, and I'm here with Dave. Say hi, Dave.
Hi, Dave.
Now, what do you do here at UL?
I'm a senior engineering technician. Okay. I help write procedures, test things, sweep a floor, whatever UL wants me to do. But mainly, I test firemen's protective equipment, helmets, garments, gloves, boots. Take a boot, for example. Would you like to participate in a test?
Sure. So, okay.
Hey Dennis, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, you're sure?
I guess so.
Here we go.
Okay,
whoa, wait a minute, whoa, stop.
Okay, wait.
Let's make sure the footwear will protect you first.
Oh, that's a great idea.
Okay, before you actually step into the flame. We want to make sure that boot is safe.
Yes.
How we can do that here at UL, we have a flame test apparatus for the fireman's boots.
Okay.
I'd like to demonstrate that for you now. You're going to stand back.
Okay.
Okay. I have a boot already prepared for the test. Now, after 1 minute, the boot is going to move over into that flame, and then for 12 seconds, it's going to burn.
Okay.
After 12 seconds, the shutters close off the flame, and we're going to make sure that boot is not on fire.
Okay.
If it's not on fire, that's a good thing. If it's on fire, that's not a good thing. We have to make sure that the equipment will protect each and every firefighter. This is one way to do that, by exposing their equipment to the actual conditions in which they may come across. We want protective equipment to fail in the test lab, not in the real world situation. No flame, good boot.
All right.
Well, hello kids, it's Terry again. What I want to show you today is how important it is to wear your safety glasses whenever you need them. So what I've done is I've set up a test. I've got another head form that's specified. And what I plan to do is take a small steel ball and I'm going to propel it through this little air gun at about 100 miles an hour. I will impact the glasses and we'll see what happens. You see, moved around a little bit, but you really didn't see a whole lot of damage, did you? So, now let's just take some regular reading glasses and let's try the same thing. Don't be fooled by a false sense of security with just having glasses on. Make sure you have a Z87 ANSI mark inside.
So what we learned here today in Research Triangle Park is that there's engineers and scientists here at UL that are dedicated to making sure that the products that we use every day are safe. They test them, whether it's through fires or dropping them or a number of different tests. But again, it's all to make sure that those products are safe for you and me. And to tell you the truth, it's actually really cool to be an engineer. For UL Safety Smart, I'm Dennis Avalar, and that's how you learn.